Kevin Kuchenbecker, Planning, Zoning, and Historic Preservation Officer for the City of Deadwood, and this is another moment in Deadwood's history. We're standing right alongside Whitewood Creek here, and behind me is a project going on. It's the FEMA project, and it's Whitewood Creek Restoration. In July of 2019, we had a pretty significant flood event come through town that wiped out some of our bulkheads and high water mark. And what we're doing here is replacing some old wooden timbers. And I'll ask Rose to pan over here. You can see some of the wooden timbers that used to be along here. And today we're putting it back in with ready block that's stained to look like rock walls. Those timbers that Rose has on the screen there date back to around 1900. This was the old rail yard, and if you remember, we had some archaeological investigations that was being done in conjunction and in advance of this project. And so then back behind me, Rose, you can see the black material, and sticking onto that, that's the corner of the roundhouse. So that was able to be saved in situ, inside and wall design, in an effort not to have any conflict with that historic resource, and also not to go into the creek where we'd have a rise and change of floodplain. This is a very complex project. It's about a $7.5 million project, and so thanks to the FEMA funding, we're able to complete this project. We started end of October, and it'll go through May of 24. They're about halfway down with the footings at creek level. You can see on here where we've had to sandbag the creek to redirect it, putting the concrete footing in there, and then these one-ton concrete blocks are being set, and they'll be about 8 or 9 high here. As you go upstream, that'll get lower and lower until we get behind Charles Street, where they'll be probably about 4 blocks high. So from about 15 feet down to 8 feet as it goes. Very, very challenging project. Archaeologically, as we're monitoring this project, we haven't found many additional artifacts. Excuse me. We've found a few bottles, which are pretty unique, but most of it is still. So this area was, you know, historically, before the railroad, part of the creek bottom. And then when the railroad came in, they built it up. And so there's not a lot of fun artifacts other than the structure that we uncovered and showed on our videos here about 6 weeks ago. A couple other interesting things with the FEMA project. Of course, we're dealing with Corps of Engineers. We're dealing with game fish and parks. We have the American Dipper, which is an endangered bird that has broods twice a year. So we've closed their nests for the winter and working with game fish and parks on that. And then also for all of the vegetation that we take out, we've got to match it one by one. When it's done, it'll be a beautiful wall that should last another 75 to 100 years. Obviously, the water will continue to erode the creek bottom. And at some time in the future, a couple generations from now, they'll be repairing this wall just because of the force of the water. But I wanted to get you an update on that. Again, the archaeological site with the roundhouse has been saved, and will actually be buried. But we've got it recorded in. It was buried since 1950, and we'll keep it for the next generation. One other thing that is kind of interesting is these bulkheads, especially behind Charles Street, didn't exist up until about 1965, Mother's Day weekend. We got 4 feet of snow, and then a big rain that weekend. And as a result, some of the bulkheads came in. Though they were wooden, they got washed out. We put the gabion baskets in 2002, and now we're doing something a little more permanent with the ready rock wall. So that's kind of an update of what's going on here in Deadwood along Whitewood Creek. This flows into Deadwood Creek. Deadwood is what we're named after. It's fun to be a part of the National Historic Landmark and see some of these projects in the region. Thank you, and that's a wrap.